Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to change your IP address on Windows 10. The method I show in this video will also work on Windows 11, so if you have Windows 11 installed on your system, you can follow along too. Starting from your desktop, do a search for Control Panel. If you don't have search displayed on the taskbar, just use the keyboard shortcut, which is Windows key and S. The Control Panel app should be the best match, so go ahead and click into that. And to get this view of Control Panel, just come over to this View By tab and change this to Small Icons. And once you've done that, you're going to find the Network and Sharing Center on this list, and then click into that. Once you get to this screen, you want to head over to the left where it says Change Adapter Settings. And now you'll see all of the network adapters on your computer. I'm recording this video on a desktop, which means I don't have Wi-Fi or a wireless network adapter. Now right here we see three network adapters. Ethernet 2 is used by the VirtualBox virtual machines, and Ethernet 3 is a VPN adapter that got installed by NordVPN. So we're going to ignore those two and just focus on Ethernet, which is the physical adapter on my motherboard. If you're using a laptop or a desktop that has a wireless network adapter, you'll see another wireless network adapter show up here in this list. And if you're using that Wi-Fi adapter to connect to any networks, you'll need to follow along to the steps that I show you on this Ethernet adapter. But in your case, you'll have to apply to the wireless network adapter that you see on this list. So to start, let's first look at our current network settings. Right-click on your network adapter and then go to Status. Once you see this screen, click on Details, and then you'll see the network connection details. Now here where it says IPv4 address, you'll see your current IP address. And you'll also need to check if DHCP is enabled, which in my case it is. This means the router that I'm connected to assigned this IP address to my computer, and we're going to change that to something else. And over here at the default gateway and the DHCP server, we can see both of those IP addresses are the same, which is the router's IP address. So let's change our IP address to something else. We can go ahead and close out of this. And with this window open, you can click on Properties. On this list, you want to find the item called Internet Protocol Version 4 and then double click on that. And then you'll get to this screen. Once you're on this screen, you want to go down to your Start menu and then right click on the Start menu. And then you want to find the option that says Windows PowerShell with Admin. Or in your case, it might say Command Prompt with Admin. And then go ahead and click on that. And then once you have this window open, you can type ipconfig and then press Enter. And now it'll display all of the IP addresses that are assigned to your computer. So the IP address that we looked at earlier was from the first Ethernet adapter. We said we're going to ignore number 2 and 3. And we can see that that is the LAN network adapter. In your case, again, it might be a wireless network adapter. So to change our IP address in Windows 10, we have to come over to this window that we opened earlier. And then click on this option that says use the following IP address. And then we can type our new IP address into this box here. Now, before we had an IP address that ended in 114, and we want to change that to something else, but we can't just enter a random number there because there might be another device on the network that already has the IP address that we're trying to change to. So to find an available IP address that we can change to, just go ahead and enter another command here, and that's called ARP space dash A, and then press enter. And now you'll see all of the IP addresses listed on your network. So once again, we're interested in this network. Just ignore the one up top. That is the VirtualBox network. And we can see on this interface, these are all the IP addresses that are currently assigned. Most of the time, you'll be able to choose an IP address in this range. In our case, the router has the IP address of .1, which we can see up there. So we can choose anything starting from 2 all the way to 255. On this list, we can see that 255 is also taken, and then the rest of these IP addresses aren't in the same range, so we're just going to ignore that as well. So we can basically choose anything between 2 and 255, which means we'll also be able to enter our current IP address, which is 114, into this box, and in that case the IP address will stay the same, but it will be a static IP address, meaning we always want the computer to have that same IP address. So in my case, I'm just going to choose another number. I'm going to choose 25. So to change the IP address, go ahead and click into this box, and then you're going to start entering the interface's IP address, which in my case is 192.168.10, and then you only change the last number. In my case, I'm going to choose 25. if I go ahead and click into the subnet mask box, it should fill automatically. And then the default gateway is your router's IP address. And we already determined that earlier. We can also get it by scrolling up on the command prompt to see what the default gateway here is. And that is the router's IP address, which is 192.168.10.1. And then for the DNS server, you can either enter your default gateway again, or what I recommend doing is using Google's DNS. And to use Google's DNS, you can fill out these two fields with the same settings that I have here. So once you're done with that, you can go ahead and click on OK, and I click on OK again, and then close this box. And you can close out of the PowerShell or command prompt window. And after that, go ahead and select your network adapter again, right click on it, choose the status option. On this screen, you can confirm if you have internet, if it is an internet connection that you're using. And then to verify if we change the IP address correctly, just click on details. And there you'll see the new IP address that you created manually. You can also see that the DHCP value changed to no, which means this IP address was not assigned to us by the router. It's a static address that we assigned to the computer ourselves. Now, if for any reason you wanted to change the IP address to something else or revert this back so the router assigns an IP address to your computer, you can just go ahead and close out of this. Go back to the properties, select the Internet Protocol version 4 setting again, and then you can change this number to another available IP address. Or if you wanted to enable DHCP again, just go ahead and click on Obtain an IP address automatically. And if you want, you can leave Google's DNS server settings in those fields. Or you can choose to obtain the DNS server directly from your router again. I'm just going to leave Google's DNS selected and then click on OK. Click on OK again. Once it's finished resetting the adapter and I've got internet, if I click on details again, I've got my old IP address back, which was assigned by the router. I do hope this helped you out. Leave a like on the video and see you in the next one.